Hi guys, in this exercise we are executing the surface area for this conventional cone. It's the skin and the exterior space on the outside of this particular cone. That's what we're looking for. Now the good news is there's one formula. We just plug and play all the values in there and we can calculate it confidently, the complete answer for the surface area of this particular cone. Now we're going to take it in three steps. Step number one is to work out the radius because we're given the diameter, so we're going to chop that in half. Step number two, we're going to write up that formula. And step number three, we're going to plug and play the values in there and work out the complete entire total surface area for this cone. Now this cone consists of two components, two parts, and that's the curved surface here and the circle area at the base right over here. And the formula will reflect that. Now all units are in centimeters, so the answer will be in centimeters squared, and the answer can be to one decimal place. So let's begin. First off, let's work out that radius because we're given the diameter here. We're going to chop that in half. So the radius, r equals a half times the diameter. The diameter is given, and the complete diameter right there at the base of this cone is 52 centimeters. So the radius for this cone is 26 centimeters. That's really useful and worthwhile to know because the formula needs the radius in there. Now the good news, as I said, the formula is one complete formula and you just put all the values in and it will give you the whole complete surface area. So let's do that now. Surface area of a cone equals pi r squared plus pi r l. Okay, let's go through and take a closer look at this formula. We have pi times r, the radius, we've already got that, that's going to be 26, plus pi times the radius again, 26 as I said earlier, and L, that capital L stands for the slant length, and that's the length that goes around there as a slant. Now it's not the perpendicular height which goes through the middle, it's the slant right along there. So the good news is that goes straight into that, that is L right there, and we have a value of 68.4 centimeters. So let's plug and play, let's substitute these values into that formula and come up with and calculate the complete entire surface area. Let's put in the radius, and that, as we said before, was 26 centimeters. So that will be 26 squared. Again, 26. And the slant length is 68.4. Okay, let's take a closer look at the formula again. Surface area for a cone, a conventional cone, pi times 26 squared, that'll give us the value of that circle area right there, that blue component, plus, this is the curved surface of the cone, pi times r, which is 26 in this case, times 68.4, the slant length as I mentioned earlier. So let's plug all that into the formula, into the calculator. So let's go pi times 26 squared, that part only, is going to give us to one decimal place 2123.7. Now let's work out the curved part here, which is pi rl, pi times 26 times 68.4, that part, the curved surface of the upper cone area, that's going to give us a value of 5587.0 for the curved part there. All we need to do now is simply add these two guys together. We'll have the complete entire surface area for that conventional cone, and that's going to yield 2123.7 plus 5587.0 equals grand total entire surface area
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.